A while ago, I did a review of Grammarly. However, in the comments, you guys left a lot asking how did it compare to ProWritingAid, as well as telling me how much you love ProWritingAid. So with that, I decided to do a Grammarly versus ProWritingAid YouTube check so we can see them side by side and figure out which one is the better between the two. If you enjoy videos like this or would like to learn more about writing and self-publishing, be sure to click the subscription button below as well as the little bell icon so that you can find out when my next video comes out. And with that, let's begin. The thing about spelling and grammar checkers is we want to make sure that they integrate into all forms of our writing. That could be online, as well as when we're sitting to write our next book, or even blog posts. So the way for grammar checkers to be able to do this seamlessly is through the way they integrate into all the different ways of writing. So let's go ahead and compare which integrations ProWritingAid and Grammarly have to see how they stack up, and then we're going to do a side-by-side comparison of each to see which one is better. To start off, both ProWritingAid and Grammarly have a Word integration plugin. Now, however, though, this only is for Windows Word, not Mac Word. Come on, can't you make a Mac Word plugin so that we can use it? Also, both of them have a Chrome plugin, which allows them to check your grammar and spelling when you're on Facebook, Twitter, writing a Gmail, any of that. They both have an online web editor where you can go ahead and write your documents and check them there. And they both have a downloadable app as well. However, ProWritingAid has a Google Docs plugin, which Grammarly doesn't. This seamlessly integrates into any writing you do in Google Docs, which I personally do a lot of writing, so that's kind of cool. And ProWritingAid also has a Scrivener integration, but we're gonna get into that just a little bit. So as you can see, ProWritingAid has a lot more integration capability than Grammarly. So we're gonna give a check mark to them for that. Now, let's do a side-by-side comparison of each one of those integrations and see which one is better. Working with Word for both of them, I didn't see any noticeable difference, so I can't give a check for this one. However, when it came to the Chrome plugin, Grammarly's was a lot better. I found that with ProWritingAid, I kept kind of hovering over their little button and it would have that pop-up box and it got really intrusive and obstructive. This became pretty annoying since it happens quite often. So I'm gonna give a check mark to Grammarly for this. Now with their web editors, as you can see, they're both very structured and pretty streamlined. But as you can tell with ProWritingAid, there are a lot of great options at the top. ProWritingAid has 25 different reports and ways to check your writing. But one thing I loved most about ProWritingAid's web editor is that I can select the style of writing that I'm doing. So when I'm working on a blog post, I can select casual. But when I'm working on, say, one of my academic papers, which I haven't done one of those in a long time, but if I did, I would select academic. I love that it switches the way it looks, and I found that a lot of the suggestions it gave were a lot better because of that. So, a check mark to ProWritingAid for their web editor. And finally, let's go ahead and look at their downloadable app. Now, this one was a little bit confusing because Grammarly's downloadable app actually opens up the web editor that we just saw, but it allows you to do it from your computer. However, with ProWritingAid, the downloadable app is actually the Scrivener integration that we just talked about. While you can open up the ProWritingAid app and you can open up certain file types and do some writing in there, I didn't exactly like this. Instead, the main function of this downloadable app is to be able to open up any of your Scrivener projects inside of it, make edits, and then save it, and it saves it inside of your Scrivener project. So that maintains your formatting, but it allows you to use the coolness of ProWritingAid to be able to edit your Scrivener work. So in truth, because both of them aren't exactly the same, I can't give a check mark for either. Okay, so with that, now that we know how they integrate into our work and the difference between those integrations, let's go ahead and look at the pricing. Now for this, I actually have a 40% discount that you can use on ProWritingAid. So the numbers you're gonna see are using that coupon, which you can find in the link in the description below in my ProWritingAid review. So using that 40% coupon, you can actually get 1 year's worth of ProWritingAid for only $30. Whereas with Grammarly, on the other hand, it's $139.95. Ouch. But what I love most about ProWritingAid's pricing is they also have a lifetime access. I'm not a fan of subscriptions, so I love the ability to buy up a great product immediately and never have to pay again. And with their price, it's only $105 using that coupon code. That's actually cheaper than 1 year of Grammarly. Huh. So for that, I'm gonna give two check marks to ProWritingAid because not only are they cheaper on an annual basis, but they also offer lifetime for one price. And finally, let's look at the core components of both, which is the spelling and grammar checker. The question is which one is better? which one gives better options as well as better recommendation. To do this, we open up 25 different articles of mine to include blog posts, books, even my thesis, and we ran it through both of them, and in truth, our results were kind of inconclusive. There were times where ProWritingAid was much better, and there were times that Grammarly was better. So we didn't have enough data to be able to say that one gets the check mark, so I can't give one to either. But then again, one thing that I did love most about ProWritingAid, which we talked about earlier, was that I could select the style, and that really changed the way it recommended things to me. So with that, I felt like the recommendations given by ProWritingAid were much better, and I could also use those reports that we talked about to learn even more. So I guess I should give a check mark to ProWritingAid for that. All right, guys. So as you can see, ProWritingAid is the clear winner with a lot more integration, usually better integrations, a much better pricing, and also in the end, I thought it was much better at teaching me how to write. But that doesn't mean that ProWritingAid is for everybody. I still like the functionality of Grammarly as I'm using it on the internet. It doesn't intrude on the things that I'm working on. But with the goal of improving my writing, I think ProWritingAid is much better. So if you're looking at a grammar and spell checker that just seamlessly integrates into your operations and is easier to use, that would be Grammarly. However, though, if you're a true writer that you're trying to develop your writing skills, make your next book, those sorts of things, ProWritingAid has much more tools to do it and to do it more effectively and efficiently. Plus, it's also a lot cheaper. Now, again, if you were thinking about getting ProWritingAid, be sure to click my review below where you can access that 40% discount that we talked about. And please understand too that every link that's on that article is an affiliate link. So I do get a commission, but that goes straight to my coffee fund. So I appreciate that if you guys do. So with that, I'm Dave Chesson of Kindlepreneur signing off. Cheers.